Hello, this presentation is a quick guide for parents like yourself to understand all of the recent changes that have occurred with high school graduation requirements and new college and career readiness requirements. Please remember that while this video will give you an overview, specific questions about your child's plan for graduation should be directed to his or her school counselor. We know that with all of the recent changes in education at the state and national levels, it's often very confusing to understand exactly what your child needs to complete in order to receive his or her high school diploma. It's our hope that after this presentation, you'll have a better understanding of what your child will need in order to graduate from Worcester County Public Schools and to be what is considered college and career ready. Also, be on the lookout for parent tips throughout this presentation. Just look for the light bulb icon on the screen. Are you ready to dive in? Great! Let's take a closer look at college and career readiness. A primary goal of Worcester County Public Schools and all school districts in the state of Maryland is to produce graduates who are fully prepared to take on the challenges of higher education and a competitive workforce. The Maryland State Legislature has taken this goal further with its passage of the College and Career Readiness and College Completion Act of 2013. This act, which is now in effect, requires that all Maryland school districts ensure students are college and career ready in the areas of English and mathematics by the conclusion of the 11th grade. There are several options to demonstrate this readiness, which we will explore more in depth later in this presentation. This act also mandates that students who have not demonstrated college and career readiness by the end of the 11th grade will be required to take what is called a transition course during their senior year. This requirement may impact scheduling for your child should he or she not meet the college and career readiness requirement. We know this is a lot of information to take in, so now we will break down exactly what is required for your child to meet the high school graduation requirements and the college and career readiness requirements. As many of these mandated changes have been rolled out by graduating class, this presentation is geared specifically for parents of students currently in the 10th grade, the class of 2018. This slide gives you a quick glance into the minimum requirements to receive the 21 credits needed to be awarded a high school diploma from the state of Maryland. We will take a deeper look at each one of these content areas as we move forward. But just a quick reminder, all of this information can be seen in full detail in the 2016-2017 High School Course Catalog. Just visit our website at www.worcesterk12.com or stop by the guidance office at your child's school to view a copy. To meet the English graduation requirement, students must earn 4 credits through the following course progression: English 9, English 10, American Literature, and British Literature. For the assessment requirements, students in the class of 2018 are required to participate in the Park English 10 assessment. Now, let's take a look at the new college and career readiness requirements. These are entirely separate from the high school graduation requirements and do not affect your child's ability to receive his or her diploma. Parent tip: don't be overwhelmed. You don't need to remember all of this text. Just look inside the course catalog if you'd like to reference these options. As stated earlier, under the College and Career Readiness and College Completion Act, your child must demonstrate that he or she is college and career ready through one of the options shown by the end of the 11th grade. If your child doesn't demonstrate college and career readiness through one of these options, he or she will be required to enroll in a transition course. Worcester County is proud to offer students a choice of a traditional transition course or an articulated transition course offered in partnership with Warwick Community College. Students in a traditional course will take the Park 11 assessment, and students in the articulated course must achieve a 75% average in the course, which includes a final exam. But remember, like we said earlier, not meeting these requirements will not affect a student's ability to receive his or her high school diploma. Now, let's move on to math. To meet the math graduation requirement, students must earn 3 credits, which must include successful completion of Algebra 1 and Geometry. Parent tip, students who took Algebra 1 in 8th grade are still required to pass 3 credits during high school. To meet assessment requirements for graduation, students in the class of 2018 must have received a passing grade in the Algebra Data Analysis HSA in grade 8 during the 2013-14 school year, or must have received a passing grade in Algebra 1 and participated in the Park Algebra 1 testing during the 2014-15 or 2015-16 school year. Now, let's take a look at the new College and Career Readiness requirements for math. Just like English, these are entirely separate from the high school graduation requirements and do not affect your child's ability to receive his or her diploma. As with English, your child must demonstrate that he or she is college and career ready through one of these options by the end of the 2016-2017 school year. Those students required to enroll in the transition course will have a choice of a traditional transition course or an articulated transition course offered in partnership with Warwick Community College. Students taking these courses should consult the course catalog for the assessment requirements at the conclusion of the course. Parent tip, the College and Career Readiness and College Completion Act of 2013 requires that all students in the class of 2018 enroll in a math course during their senior year. Therefore, students should carefully plan their next 2 years of math courses. And again, we want to stress that not meeting these college and career readiness requirements will not affect the student's ability to receive his or her high school diploma. The class of 2018 is not affected by pending changes to the content areas of science and social studies. Additionally, the College and Career Readiness and College Completion Act applies only to English and mathematics. So these requirements remain unchanged from prior years. As with science and social studies, these additional content area requirements for graduation remain unchanged from prior years. High school students also have a number of available options to meet the program choice graduation requirement. They can complete 2 credits in world language, 2 credits in advanced technology, or complete a CTE program. Parent tip, while high school graduation requirements list 4 credits in a CTE completer program, some completer programs require more than 4 credits to complete the program. Now, let's see how career and technical education programs fit into the new College and Career Readiness requirements. The College and Career Readiness and College Completion Act stipulates that if a student doesn't demonstrate college and career readiness in English and or mathematics by the end of grade 11, they must enroll in a transition course during their senior year. The law requires that they take a college and career readiness reassessment during their senior year. However, students enrolled in certain CTE programs can meet the college and career readiness reassessment requirement if they successfully complete their CTE program and pass the technical assessment that leads to licensure or industry certification. Parent tip, please check with the counselor at Worcester Technical High School to see if your program's technical assessment will meet this requirement. We hope this presentation has given you some insight into how your child will reach that important milestone of graduation. If you have additional questions, we encourage you to make an appointment to sit down with your child's school counselor and review these options discussed here today. Thank you for watching.